Fool Game Pro, martial artist, sharpshooter, game reviewer, director.
Hey guys, Fool Game Pro here. I just needed to make a clarification on something here. Maybe I'll do another video more about it at a later point. First off, I want to say I had a really bad weekend. Not going to get into it really, but so I might be a little snippy in my comments and responses, and so I apologize for that if I go off on anybody. Some bad stuff happened. So anyway, I wanted to clarify about using Birdshot. Now I don't know if maybe some of you guys aren't. When I do a video, I try to explain myself very well, and it's probably my fault. It's probably I'm not explaining myself well enough. And I link to other videos that try to convey what I'm trying to say with my Birdshot video. My last Birdshot video, I show the effectiveness of it, but I also linked in that video to, I believe, three other videos that I've made talking about using a shotgun. And as you can see, the Birdshot at close range is very effective. There's no denying it. It is very effective on real flesh. If somebody's armored, no, it's not effective. But then again, if they're armored, then, you know, your 9mm, your 45 is not effective. I mean, really, how many what ifs are you going to have? You got to look, everybody, this is something that I said, I think I put it in the description, is you have to look at your own state laws and your own state, your own house, what you live in. Not when somebody, when I do one of these videos and show effectiveness, I'm not saying that this is your do-all, win-all round. I'm saying that it is effective. And as I said in the video, it is effective at close range using a full choke. In the links that I showed if you go further than close range, you're just going to piss the person off unless you hit them in the head. It's not going to blow their head off, but it will, you know, the scatter shot will, you know, depending on your choke and everything. And even if it's not, you know, the choke, it's, if it gets in their eyes, they're blinded, you know. You don't want to get lead in you either, okay? So, I'm not saying this is the beat-all, win-all shot, no. As I said in many of the videos and in the descriptions and comments, it depends on your circumstances. Okay, are you going to want to use buckshot or slugs if you have gas lines? No. Okay, I sleep on one end of the house, and my other rooms of the house are on the other end. Okay, if I had children, I would be probably using buckshot as an option instead of, birdshot instead of buckshot. Because I don't want it to scatter into somebody else's room and hit one of my kids. If I'm in an apartment building, I don't want to, you know, get my next door neighbor from a bad shot. A video I watched, you know, the guy said he was very against birdshot. We're not all tactical. No, you're not all tactical. And some of you guys have figured out that there's a little bit more in my past than what I say. But I try to make it as normal person as possible. Anyhow, no, this is not a do-all, okay? You've got to look at your circumstances in your house, if you're in an apartment, if you live out in the wilderness, there's so many variables. You have to be the one that decides what to use. Okay? I'm just showing the effectiveness. Okay? There's, I mean, if you're going to put variables into it, I mean, what if the robber goes behind a refrigerator and shooting at you? Okay, well, what are you going to use then? Okay, how many fucking damn, you know, ways are you going to say, oh, it's not going to go through 2x4s? Well, what's the chance of hitting a 2x4 when you're shooting through a wall? I mean, the distance is, depending on your home, your state, and your local laws, is the distance between 2x4s. They can be, I believe, up to 18 inches. So, you got to look at a lot of factors. You also got to look at what walls your walls are made of. My house is a very old house. It's got drywall and plaster. You know, I got really strong exterior walls, but I've showed what can happen with even strong exterior walls. If you have brick, you know. If you have other family in the house. Now, with my wife, before I got her, even with the pistol, you got to look at how you're gonna convey your house, how you're gonna get in, you know, look at your house. I mean, a lot of people have the mentality of staying in a room. A lot of areas have the law of you have to stay in your room and you cannot go and search the rest of your house. You got to call for the police. You've got to look at many, many factors. So for my wife, I have her with a shotgun, and I don't have her with birdshot. No, I don't have her with birdshot because there's nobody else in the house but her and I. Okay? And she's not going to shoot me because I say a phrase before coming back in the room after I do my rounds. And, you know, she loads it up with our heavy steel load. Okay? But from the angle, from where she's at, it's not going to go through anything other than the roof, pretty much, and she's well protected where she's at while I do my rounds. Now, me, I don't use a shotgun. I've talked about this before. I don't use a shotgun, but shotgun is a very, very great tool. And the reason why I don't use a shotgun is because my back, I can't hold it that long. But it's not just that. My house is a small house. It's 1,200 square feet house. But it's got a lot of twists and turns, little hallways, and all that, okay? So, I use a pistol, all right? I use a 9mm. I got it with 17 rounds, the Hornady, whatever, hell, I don't care, rounds. Yes, that's loaded. This is my home defense pistol. I do not have it. Actually, anything in the chamber, as indicated, there's nothing there. That's what I use, all right? And I've talked about this. And when I go outside, I use that, okay? Why do I use this when I go outside and this in the home? Well, this is a smaller pistol. I can hold this and control it tons better than I can control this one. But I have more training on this. I'm not gonna go too much into it, but main point of when I use this outside is our laws in Oregon, we do not have castle laws. So I cannot protect the house from somebody just stealing something. Castle laws, you can protect the house from somebody stealing from you. You can go ahead and shoot them. In Oregon, if there is a way to exit, you must exit the house. You may only shoot if they are creating immediate danger to you. That's the only time that you can shoot in Oregon. I actually do search the house. I go room to room and search the house, because nobody's gonna take advantage of me, you know, and I will shoot them. I do not have an issue with it. I'm not gonna get into it, but I don't have an issue with it. That's really, I mean, you can go, you know, well, then a 9mm is not going to be strong enough because they're going to be hiding behind a refrigerator. I don't know. They got a steel plate on. You don't know what they're going to be wearing. Well, what the hell, you know? Are we all just going to, you know, carry a 50 caliber? Or are we going to all going to carry some of those illegal 7.5 rounds, the armor-piercing ones? No, we can't get them. So, you know, there's lots of variables that you can put in there, but you've have to see what your laws are. You have to see what you're comfortable with firing with. To see if you know, if there's going to be backslash. Now, I am a person that I would rather be carried. I'm sorry, I'd rather be judged by 12 than carried by 6, and that's why I search the house. I'd rather be judged than to just be a victim and be shot. And I do have to search the house. I don't know what's going on. You know, I'm not looking to kill someone, but I'm not going to back down. So anyway, again, I'm not saying that this is the win-all. I'm just saying it is effective in the right circumstances. A 22 is effective in the right circumstances. Shot placement. You can go on and on. I mean, even with a slug or a buckshot, you know, you still got to aim it. So, yeah. I hope this makes sense. Please, guys, when you look at my videos and I put links to things, you know, really look at what we got there. I mean, when you guys say, well, it's not, you know, I'd rather have something for, you know, for distance. Well, that's great. You know, if you have a large house and you got, you know, you don't have to worry about where the shots are landing. If you miss, then well, great, you know, great for you. But you know, the shot, it's, you can't. Main point is your circumstances, your laws, and your home is not like everybody else's. It might be the same for you and your community, but it's not the same for everybody. So everybody's got to choose something, and they got to look out there to see if it's a viable option. I mean, it would really suck for a lot of those places that, you know, it's illegal to use buckshot for home defense. You've got to really look at your laws, and I don't mean just state laws. I mean, you got to look at your county and your city ordinance for these things. So, and I've talked about this, and I know, you know, looking through my videos, sometimes it can take a couple hours. But I do put some, you know, information out there. Yeah. So anyway, I just wanted to put that out there. I hope this makes sense, guys. If you have any questions, you know, I'm not saying don't put your comments down. Put your comments down, you know, and we'll discuss things. And you know, there's might be a way to, you know, sway my mind or what, one way or another, but it's not really, like I said, I'm not saying this is a win-all, you know, device. But, you know, look at a 1919. If you have a 1919, is that, you know, that's going to be blowing through the crap through most things, but is that a viable option? I mean, yeah, you got all the power, but could you really take that room to room? No. Every weapon has its place, and not all home and environments are the same. If they were, every Marine would have one weapon, and every Army, every soldier would have one weapon. You know, I mean, and everybody would have the same ammo. That's not... Yeah, the whole ammo war and stuff like that is just silly. You gotta look at a lot of variables. All right, you guys, I'll take care.